in the fertility. What could be the reason for the decrease in the fertility? There are many reasons. It could be because of the gametes, the eggs of the lady, the sperms of the male, the uterus in the lady, the problem with the quality of the eggs and the sperms in both of them, problems in formation of the embryo, formation of the endometrium, that is the uterus lining, which is important for the implantation of a very well-grown embryo. What is embryo? It's the baby which is going to be formed later. The embryo is formed by a combination of the egg from the lady and the sperms, one among these sperms from the man. And this is going to produce the embryo, which later will develop into the fetus or the baby. Now, what are necessary for the pregnancy? Very important ones basically are the seeds, the gametes, the male sperms and the female eggs, along with the soil, whichever is needed, that is the uterine receptivity, or otherwise the receptivity of the uterus, which is the organ that takes up the well-formed embryo. This is just the basics of what a fertility is. Now, there is a difference in the trend observed between the rural and the urban group of population, which you can see that rural people have a very low fertility rate, which have always been less, and it is in the declining trend. Minus 40, minus 31, minus 19. This shows a decreasing trend throughout years. So compared to even the urban population, we see a lot of rural population having this fertility issues, on contrary to what we usually think. They have a very good food, they have a very healthy kind of a lifestyle because they work more, they are not sedentary. All these are thought by us, but it is proven otherwise by the statistics that in the rural area, compared to even urban people, the chances of infertility is increasing. If there is a decrease in the quality and the quantity of the gametes, the sperms in the man and the eggs in the woman, what happens? There is no good production of embryos. So even if you have a receptivity good uterus, it's not going to produce an implantation. It is not going to produce a pregnancy, at least in the first few shots. So having a good egg, quality-wise and quantity-wise, and having a good sperm, quality-wise and quantity-wise again, is important to produce a good embryo. What happens in a lady after about 30, 35 years of age, which was earlier 40 years, but now even at 30, 35 years, we see that the number of follicles in a lady's reproductive organ called ovary is decreasing. And because there is a decrease in the number of follicles in the reproductive organ, there is less number of oocytes or the eggs that is formed. Because of a decrease in the number of oocytes, we have very less amount of eggs in which we can work and produce embryos. Even by nature, there is a possibility of decrease in the quantity and quality of the eggs in a lady with increasing age. So, now, only option that the lady will have after 40, 45 years, when the ovaries are completely drained out, there is no eggs at all in the reproductive organ, then they have to depend on third-party reproduction, which is otherwise called the donor eggs. Somebody who similarity has to be identified, and she has to resemble the lady, she has to have the same blood group, she should not have problems, she should not have hereditary problems, she should not have infectious problems, the family should be free from genetic problems because we do not know the genetics of the donor. All these, of course, are being checked legally. When we follow the OD-ICSI program, we do make sure that all these are done. But still, how good is to have one's own gametes, even when it is less? Is there a chance that I have my own gametes, my own genetics, to be transferred to the next generation of mine? Now, how would we be able to avoid the third-party reproduction? Third-party reproduction is where the couple depend on either another woman for her eggs, or another man for the donor sperm, or they depend on the donor embryo altogether. How can we avoid this? Now, even with male factor, there is a decrease in the quantity as well as the quality of the sperm factors. The count of the sperms at a given age, the quality of the sperms at a given age, the motility, because only the actively moving sperms are capable of converting the eggs into embryos, the morphology of these sperms, all these factors also show a decreasing trend. There are various environmental factors, electromagnetic radiations, the food factor, the sleeplessness, the lifestyle factor, the obesity. Everything is being identified that it could be one of the factors to produce a decrease in the fertility. But we aren't sure, we are not specific in identifying exactly what is the factor which is causing a decrease or a decline in the fertility throughout. So we look at all the factors and try to avoid all these genetic and the environmental factors as much as possible. Worldwide, for a decrease in the quality or quantity of the oocytes and the sperms, the best thing that we have at hand is ICSI or IVF, what we normally call as test tube program. That's the one we know as of now. If the sperms are less, if the eggs are less, we try to go ahead with the program of test tube baby. Try and produce babies through their own gametes with a process called IVF and technically an advanced program called ICSI, ICSI or intracytoplasmic sperm injection. What do we have beyond this? Is there anything else to improve the gametes? Whenever we come across a low oocyte or low sperm beyond a normal IVF or an ICSI program, we do suggest donor gametes. But there are a lot of things involved in using the donor gametes. Law, legality, genetics that could be changed, lot of dilemmas within the family in deciding whether they want to go ahead with their own oocytes, their own sperms, or to go ahead with a third-party reproduction. It is not very easy for the couple to digest this and come across all the questions that happens to them and then finally decide on the OD program or a donor sperm program. And rearing the child, whether to save the child, whether not to save the child, whether to tell their relatives, at least the close relatives, all in dilemma. What are the advantages of having one's own gametes? As we all know, the parents, the genetics of the parents is going to define the genetics of the child. Not only the resemblance, not only the characteristics, many things among the genetics is going to be the same from the parents. Pride of having their own characters in their progeny is something which a couple would always want to have. And there is no mixing up of gametes. There is no third party here involved, only the couple. So there is no mix up of the genetics. There is no third party reproduction. And there is no legal liability, there is no social liability, because there is no gamete which is used from outside. And no fears about transmission of any of the genetic problems or infections which could otherwise be unnoticed if not properly selected in the OD program or a donor sperm program or an embryo donation program. So, before jumping on to the third-party reproduction in people who have very low sperms or very low quantity and quality of oocytes, what are the alternatives which we give as choice to the patients? Let them select which is right for them. Let them decide with or without their family. So the cafeteria is available when the oocytes are of low quantity and quality. For the quality, we have something called a growth hormone protocol and some D-aspartic acid. We can go ahead with pooled ICSI cycle, which means we go ahead with more than one IVF cycle, pool the embryos, very minimal amount of embryos which are available, one or two, that can be pooled, and then we go ahead with transfer. Sometimes duo stimulation, IVF being done in two phases of the same cycle instead of just one, which we do in an ordinary IVF cycle. And as far as the quantity of the eggs to be improved, we have been already using some medications like DHEAS, but now recently ovarian rejuvenation with either stem cell therapy, which are taken from the same woman, or use of plasma reactivated platelets can also be used. And of course, in people who are aged about 30-35 years of age, still has not found a partner, then the gametes of those people can be frozen for future use. The gametes which are frozen at 30 years are 30 in age, in biological age, even when the lady or a gent becomes 40 years of age. So the age, reproductive age, or the biological age of the gametes can remain the same when cryopreserved. So that is another option. It's called social freezing of the eggs or the gametes. And oncofertility. We come across a lot of people now with cancer who have a lot of remedies thanks to the